This is a Creative Minds production, where the reality of your vision and video is our mission.
Whose membership Albert Gunner never gave in a word until his demise. Beginning with Thanksgiving, I wish to thank God in a special way for the gift of this great man, Archbishop Gunner Nebogiefune. Many of us know him too well. We know his background, we know his history. What he was able to sacrifice his life for the service of God. It wasn't by his grace, it was by the grace of God. And we shall ever remain grateful to God for the gift of such a human person to humanity. I also wish to thank in a special way the Yoruba community, both in Germany, India, up the United States of America, for their consistent support to his great admission when he became sick. But I must not forget to mention his great Archbishop of Onitsha, the current Archbishop of Onitsha, Archbishop Val A.A., who consistently gave him the support to take care of himself. Because usually when you retire, you are hardly the priority of the church anymore. The church still remembers you, cares for you, but then the attention shifts from you to your successor. And yet, the successor continues to support him in his retirement until he becomes sick. I have to mention a couple of names, but if I forget your name, please forgive me. I have to mention in a special way our dear sister Augustina. In all honesty, somebody called her the mother Teresa of our own time. It's amazing to me how somebody can consistently forgo a lot of her time, her pleasure, her confidence. She just finished her program of studies in Germany, was about to go back home, and was called upon to wait and see if she could make the admission. That was it. And she consistently sat by his side as he went through her. And I know myself, sometimes those who look after the sick are more sick than the sick person. For her to be there for that bishop to go through 11 surgeries and 33 chemotherapies, for her to be there, for me, is incomprehensible, is beyond human conception. And yet, every time you call on the phone, she has the best voice to receive the call and to give you the update on the condition of the admission. And so, Sister Augustina, this is just a prelude to what God has in store for you and what the admission is going to do for you now that this meeting is over the agenda. I wish you very much grateful. Thank you very much. May God bless you and your family. I know that there were so many people who helped out in Germany and in India where His Grace went for treatment. God knows best, and I reward each and every one of them as God knows best. The most we know is here in the U.S. Let me also recognize in a special way Nam Wobel. Nam is not a distant person from the admission. It is seven blood and water. And I didn't know Nam before. I knew his younger brother, Azogia. I went to school with Azogia. But amazingly, he show the character of somebody who cares, as the Archbishop said, and was there more than anybody that demanded him. So on behalf of the Vocational Association of Oraou, I would just say thank you and very big way. I pray that God was most abundantly. The rest of the Oraou community here in Houston, under the chairmanship of Chukwuemeka Anana, we thank you very, very much for being there for the admission. Our prayer continues to be, as you were there for him, God will always be there for you in times of need, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I will not forget the priest who became the host of that bishop when he came here, but a blessing one of Ahagwelo. I don't know whether it's here, I don't even know him as a person. But I understand that he significantly undertook upon himself to provide accommodation even without prior information or prior anybody asking him for it. He took the initiative and decided to provide accommodation for Bishop and for Sister Augustine. Wherever he is, I'm yet to know him, but I assure him that our association back home and those of us who are here will ever be grateful to you and to you and the congregation. There are a lot of others who we are part of. Of course, I will not forget Chief AOB. I don't know him personally. For his effort to see that that bishop kept the doors for this treatment and for his financial support. Like I said, God is going to reward each and every one of us as God knows best. Archbishop, we know him, is resting now. Those of us who know him too well. There were two occasions I wanted to give him, and the message of the Lord, what happened to somebody? Because I kept doing it more and more because he went to school with my uncle. My uncle was born in 1930, he was born in 1931. So we were close family friends even before he became a bishop. Of course, when he became a bishop, the gap, he had to keep the gap because of, the ecclesiastical responsibilities. On two occasions, I wanted to get bishop seriously. Those who have to take care of those who are selfless in the service of the Lord.